Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to round off a decimal or float number into two places in C++. So I'll be showing you two ways how you can do this. So let's get started. So in the first method, I will be using the set precision inbuilt function. This is present in the header file iomanip. So instead of using that header file, we can just directly include the bit/std.c++.h. So you can do whatever you want. I will be going with bit/. Okay. So now let me just declare a float variable. So float f equal to, let me have the value as 12.4567. Yeah, so don't forget to include this. And in the next line, it's going to be cout fixed and set precision. All right, and within the bracket, you want to specify the number of digits after decimal or the number of places. So here I'm going to do 2, so I'll just put 2 over here. And next is that float variable name, which is f in my case. That's it. Saving it now and executing and running it. So I need to get 12.46. yeah, it's getting rounded off to 2 decimal places. And if you want 3, you can just put 3 over here. I will be getting, I guess, 12.457. yeah, I'm getting that. But the issue with this method is that here you can only print that particular value. I guess you can't store that value in another float variable. So now let me also show you like how you can do that. It's quite complicated, but anyway, I will show you. We will be using string and string stream to accomplish that. So let me just go here and I will have string yes and string stream ss, and instead of cout, I will just put ss. And in the next line, it's going to be s equal to, that is our string equal to ss dot and str. Okay, all right, I'm converting the string stream to string, and we need to have a float variable as well. So for that, float rounded off value. Okay, and the next line is going to be rf equal to stof of our string. Okay, it's, as I told you, it's quite complicated. The second method I will be showing you will be like quite simple. You can follow that if you want. So anyway, I will be showing this as well. So just see out rf, I'm saving it and now running it. So here you can see I'm getting the rounded off value, but this is not of the type string, it is of the type float, because I'm printing rf, which is of type float. So this is the first method. I think it's quite complex. Yeah, so now I will be showing you the second method. Okay, so just remove this as well. So second method also is also good to have this bit/std.c++.h, and it's going to be, let me have my float variable, float rf equal to, what you're doing is round our float variable f asterisk 100 slash 100. All right, next line I'll just put cout rf. So I'll explain you how this works basically. So what round function does is that it basically like rounds off a number to its nearest whole number. So it's, if it's 12.4567, means it'll be rounding off to 12, because 12 is quite nearer to 12.45. If it was 12.5, means it will be getting rounded off to 13, because that is quite closer. That's the nearest whole number basically. So now what we are doing here is that at first we will be multiplying our float value into 100. So it will be like this, 12.4567 asterisk 100, which will be equal to 1245.67. okay, this will be the value at first, and then we will be rounding off. After rounding off only, we will divide it by 100. So what will happen to this value is that it will be getting converted into 1246. The reason is because this, it's 5.67. This is quite closer to the whole number 1246. So it will be getting converted to this, and after that we will be dividing it by 100. So we will be, at the end we will be getting 12.46. That's the rounded off value, I guess. That's the thing that we got when we are using that set precision as well. So this is the basic workflow of this line. It seems to be a simple line, but there's so much logic behind that. That's great. And now let me just now save it and run it. Yeah, here you can see I'm getting 12.46, and I guess this also works for 3 decimal places as well. I guess you need to go with 1000, I guess. So I will go with 1000. I'm saving it now and executing it. Yeah, I'm getting 12.457. So these are some of the two ways, I guess, in C++. And if you know any other simple way, you can basically like just comment that in this video. And I hope you have found this video useful. Mine is a programming channel. I run also many videos in C++, C, Java, Python, Blender, Node.js, React.js, SQL queries as well. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.